Good morning, dear all students. Hope you are all doing good. So we are discussing about a chapter, alcohols, phenols, ethers. So in that, we are discussing about some of the reactions in phenols. So in phenols, there are a number of reactions. In that, especially the named reactions are very, very important, like and Kolbe's reaction, Riemann-Thiemann reaction, and reactivity with zinc dust. So these are all very, very important, as I told in the last class. So in the last class we discuss the reaction, isn't it? So here in today's class, so we have to discuss this oxidation of a phenol. So when phenol undergo oxidation, what happens? When a phenol undergo oxidation, it always forms a diketone. Diketone will be formed. So it is somewhat like this. So if we have a phenol, when a phenol undergo oxidation, oxidation in the sense oxygen is needed in the presence of Na2Cr2O7, sodium dichromate, it's very important, sodium dichromate, oxidation takes place. So what is the product you are going to get? We are going to get a diketone. So two oxygen are connected in para position. So diketone, two ketone, diketone is present. So this is what we call it as benzoquinone. So we discussed this in the last class. Benzoquinone. So here you have to use sodium dichromate, not sodium chromate. We have to use sodium dichromate. So when a benzene which is having an alcoholic group, that is a phenol, when it is undergo oxidation, formation of a diketone, or we call it as a benzoquinone, is formed. So this is oxidation of a phenol. So hope this is clear. So these are all the reactions which involves in phenol. So now we have to know regarding some of the commercially important alcohols. What are some of the commercially important alcohols? Mainly methanol and ethanol are the two commercially important alcohol. So methanol is we also call it as a wood spirit. Wood spirit anta karitara adana. So hege prepare martiri methanol alla? Methanol is just prepared by mixing carbon monoxide with H2O. So formation of methanol takes place. So that is method of preparation of methanol. And one more is how to prepare ethanol. Ethanol is C2H5OH. That is what we call it as ethanol. So ethanol is obtained by the fermentation process. So what is that fermentation? So if you have a ripened fruit like grapes, ನೀವು ದ್ರಾಕ್ಷಾರಸ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿರ್ತೀರಿ, ವೈನ್ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿರ್ತೀರಿ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಂಟೈನ್ ಇಥೆನಾಲ್. ಹೌ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಸಿಂಥಸೈಸ್ ಇಟ್, ಹೇಗೆ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ ಅದನ್ನು? ಸೊ ಇಥೆನಾಲ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ಫ್ರೂಟ್ಸ್ ಸಚ್ ಆಸ್ ಗ್ರೇಪ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಗೋ ಫರ್ಮೆಂಟೇಷನ್, ದ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಫರ್ಮೆಂಟೇಷನ್. ಸೊ ಯೂಶಲಿ ಎ ಫ್ರೂಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅ ಸುಕ್ರೋಸ್, ರೈಟ್? ಶುಗರ್ ಕಂಟೆಂಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದೇರ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಸುಕ್ರೋಸ್. ಸೊ ಸುಕ್ರೋಸ್ ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಮ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಕಾಂಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಎನ್ ಎನ್ಝೈಮ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಟೇಸ್, ಸುಕ್ರೋಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಗ್ಲೂಕೋಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫ್ರುಕ್ಟೋಸ್. ಏನ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ? ಗ್ಲೂಕೋಸ್ ಮತ್ತು ಫ್ರಕ್ಟೋಕ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಯಾವುದು? ಸುಕ್ರೋಸ್. ಸುಕ್ರೋಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಗ್ಲೂಕೋಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫ್ರಕ್ಟೋಸ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್, ದಿಸ್ ಗ್ಲೂಕೋಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫ್ರಕ್ಟೋಸ್ ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಮ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಕಾಂಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಅನದರ್ ಎನ್ಝೈಮ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಈಸ್ಟ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಝೈಮೇಸ್. ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಮ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಕಾಂಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಅ ಝೈಮೇಸ್, ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್? ಫರ್ಮೆಂಟೇಷನ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಲಿಬರೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಡೈಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್. ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ಎ ಫರ್ಮೆಂಟೇಷನ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್, we are going to get ethanol as a product. So this is how they synthesize. Okay, so if we have glucose C6H12O6, when it is come in a contact with an enzyme zymase, at that time what happen? what happens? So here C6H12O6, so that is going to convert it into C2H5OH, okay, with the liberation of carbon dioxide. I have not written a balanced equation here. Balanced equation is not written here. So this is a phenomenon. So in a generally helbekuntadre, iga hannu ಯಾವ ಹಣ್ಣು ದ್ರಾಕ್ಷಿ ಹಣ್ಣು ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಹಣ್ಣಾದಾಗ ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ ಅದರ ಹೊರಗಿನ ಕವರಲ್ಲಿ ಈಸ್ಟ್ ಜನರೇಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅದು ಹಾಗೆ ನೀವು ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ವಿದೌಟ್ ಎನಿ ಏರ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ನೀವು ಇಡಬೇಕು ಅದನ್ನು ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಕಂಟೈನರ್ಲಿ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ ಓಪನ್ ಕಂಟೈನರ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ಟರೆ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಅದು ಇಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ಡ್ ಒನ್ ದ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಇನ್ ಅನರೋಬಿಕ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ಡ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮಲ್ಲಿ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಸೊ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ ರೈಪನ್ದ್ ಫ್ರೂಟನ್ನು ಹಾಕ್ತೀರಿ ಸೊ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಸಮ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಸುಕ್ರೋಸ್ ಇದ್ದಿದ್ದು ದಟ್ಸ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಇಂಟು ಗ್ಲೂಕೋಸ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಸಮ್ ಟೈಮ್ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ಸೊ ದ ರೈಪನ್ಡ್ ಫ್ರೂಟ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಯಾವುದು ಗ್ರೇಪ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ರೈಪನ್ ಒನ್ ಸೊ ಔಟರ್ ಕವರ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಗ್ರೇಪ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ವಿಲ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಝೈಮೇಸ್ ಈಸ್ಟ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಅನ್ ಝೈಮೇಸ್ ಎಂಜೈಮ್ ಸೊ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಎಟ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಎನ್ ಇಥೆನಾಲ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಲಿಬರೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಡೈಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೌ ದೇ ಸಿಂಥೆಸೈಸ್ ಇಥೆನಾಲ್ ಆರ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಎಸ್ ಎ ವೈನ್ ಜ್ಯೂಸ್ ವೈನ್ ಏನು ಕರಿತೀರದು ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಈಗ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಇಫ್ ದರ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಹೋಲ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಕಂಟೈನರ್ ಏನೋ ಒಂದು ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಹೋಲ್ ಇತ್ತು ಅಂತ ಇಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ ಏನಾದ್ರು ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಬಂತು ಅಂತ ಇಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ ಅವಾಗ ಏನಾಗತ್ತೆ ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ಎನ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಟು ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಎಟ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ದ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಇನ್ ಏರೋಬಿಕ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇನ್ ಅನರೋಬಿಕ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಂಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಎಟ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ದ ಟೇಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ವೈನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ನಾಟ್ ಗುಡ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ವೆನ್ ಎ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಆರ್ ವೆನ್ ಎ ಫರ್ಮೆಂಟೇಷನ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಪ್ರೆಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಎಟ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ದ ಟೇಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಲೆಸ್ ಸೊ ದ್ಯಾರ್ ಫೋರ್ ಯೂಶ್ವಲಿ ಈ ವೈನ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಟೇಸ್ಟ್ಫುಲ್ ಟೇಸ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿರಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಗುವಾಗಲೂ ಯಾವಾಗಲೂ ಎನರೋಬಿಕ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಆಗಬೇಕು ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಗಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಕಮರ್ಷಿಯಲಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಆಲ್ಕೋಹಲ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮೆಥನಾಲ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಇಥೆನಾಲ್ ಹೋಪ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಓಕೆ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಮೂವ್ ಆನ್ ಟು ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ದ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಟಾಪಿಕ್ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಮೈನ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಆಲ್ಕೋಹಾಲ್ ಫಿನಾಲ್ಸ್ ಈಥರ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಈಥರ್ We discuss alcohol, right? What are alcohol? Hydroxyl group, which is attached to the alkyl group. That is what we call it as alcohol. Phenols are those where hydroxyl group is attached to an aromatic ring. Then we call it as a phenol. Yes. Next, ether. What are these ethers? Ether hedra enagadre. Again, in ether also, we have to study the characters of ether. Like in alcohol and phenol, here also we have to study what are ethers, IUPAC nomenclature of that, then method of preparation, after that method of reactions. That much we have to study. So we'll move on to the next one, that is ethers. So what are these ethers? Ethers helidre eno? What is the general formula of ether? Ethers are those where the hydrogen of an hydroxyl group is removed by an alkyl or an aryl group. If you have an hydrogen of an hydroxyl group, if you have, let us imagine you have an alcohol, okay? Alcohol alli ROH is the formula. So if you remove hydrogen, to the place of hydrogen, if any alkyl group or aryl group comes and attach, then it becomes ether. So general formula becomes ROR. General formula enaitu ROR. So ROR. So here oxygen, which is connected to an alkyl or aryl group. So if two alkyl groups are there, if it becomes alkyl ether. If it is an aryl group, it is there, then it becomes aryl ether. Hope this is clear. So where R may be an CH3, C2H5 or C6H5, any group. Can I write any group in that? So this is regarding ethers. Ethers are those where oxygen is connected to the two alkyl or aryl group is said to be an ethers. Okay, in ethers also there are two categories. One is symmetrical ether, another one is unsymmetrical ether. What are that symmetrical ether? Symmetrical andre eno athwa unsymmetrical ether andre eno? Symmetrical ethers are those where two alkyl groups are same. Both are same. ಈ ಕಡೆ ಆಲ್ಕೈಲ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಮೀಥೈಲ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಈ ಕಡೆನೂ ಏನಿರುತ್ತೆ ಮೀಥೈಲ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಈಗ ಆರ್ ಓ ಆರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ಈ ಥರ ಬರೆದ್ರೆ ಸಿ ಹೆಚ್ ತ್ರೀ ಓ ಸಿ ಹೆಚ್ ತ್ರೀ ಅಂತ ಬರೆದ್ರೆ ಸೊ ಏನಾಯ್ತು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಸಿ ಹೆಚ್ ತ್ರೀ ಹಿಯರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಸಿ ಹೆಚ್ ತ್ರೀ ಇಸ್ಂಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಸಿ ಹೆಚ್ ತ್ರೀ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಸಿ ಹೆಚ್ ತ್ರೀ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಇದೆ ಇಲ್ಲೂ ಕೂಡ ಸಿ ಹೆಚ್ ತ್ರೀ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಇದೆ ಎರಡೂ ಕಡೆನೂ ಸಿ ಹೆಚ್ ತ್ರೀ ಸಿ ಹೆಚ್ ತ್ರೀ ಇದೆ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಸೇಮ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಆನ್ ಐದರ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ ಸಿಮೆಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಈಥರ್ಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಟೂ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಸಿ ಟು ಎಚ್ ಫೈ ಓ ಸಿ ಹೆಚ್ ತ್ರೀ ಸಿ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಿ ಟು ಎಚ್ ಫೈ ಇನ್ ಒನ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಸಿ ಟು ಎಚ್ ಫೈ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಇನ್ ಅನದರ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಸಿ ಹೆಚ್ ತ್ರೀ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ Two different alkyl groups are present on either side of ether, isn't it? So one the C2H5 ide illi illi CH3 ide two different groups are there. So therefore what happens, this becomes an unsymmetrical ether. So remember it, one is symmetrical ether, another one is unsymmetrical ether. Symmetrical ethers are those where two alkyl groups are same on either side of the oxygen. If two alkyl groups and aryl groups are different on either side of the oxygen, then that kind of ether we call it as unsymmetrical ether or asymmetrical ether. Yes? Okay. So that is regarding what are ethers, how you can classify an ether. Then how to name an ether? Ether ana heg name martiri? How you name it? Heg name martiri itarana? So IUPAC nomenclatures of ether. IUPAC nomenclature of ethers. IUPAC nomenclature of ethers. So if we have an ether, we know that general formula is R O R, isn't it? In the place of R, if I write CH3 O CH3, what is the common name? How many methyl groups are there? Two methyl groups. So common name becomes, I will write common name for few compound, then IUPAC nomenclature. Common name and IUPAC nomenclature. Okay. So here, if it is CH3O CH3, dimethyl ether, the name becomes dimethyl. Ether. Yes? So what is the name of IUPAC nomenclature? What is the word we are using? Here functional group is ether, right? Then we use suffix as oxy, right? Oxy. So if you consider this as a parent child, which is involving a functional group, this becomes a substituent. At that time, how to name it? So this is methoxy, methoxy group, methoxy methane. Yes, clear? Methoxy methane. Name becomes methoxy methoxy methane. The name becomes methoxy methane. So if we have a group somewhat like this, CH3 CH2O CH3. Then how to name it? So here it's an unsymmetrical ether. Here it contain one methyl group. Here it contain two alkyl groups. So you have to consider a chain which is having a more number of oxygen. Yes. So name becomes what is IUPAC nomenclature? Ethoxy 1,2 ethoxy methane. Yes. The name becomes ethoxy methane. The name becomes ethoxy methane. So if we have a group where it has a group somewhat like this, how to name it? Explain only IUPAC nomenclature. Here it is CH3, isn't it? How to name it? See, it is CH3O CH2. 1, 2, 3, it becomes CH, right? CH3O CH. Here CH3 CH3. So how to name it? You have to select one chain as a parent chain. It should have more number of carbon atom in it. So illi enagtadaga, so 1, 2, 3. So this becomes a parent chain. Yes. So it include an functional group ether. So this becomes a parent chain at that time. Yes. This becomes a substituent. So you have to give a number in such a way that functional group should get the least number. So if I start from here, 1, 2, 3, or if I start from here, this carbon will get a same number. So you can give the number from any side. So 1, 2, 3. In a second position, there is a substituent. Yes. Second position alle ondu substituent ide. E group, oxygen group includes to the functional group, right? So functional group. So adu parent chain ke include aayitu. So illige enagide ondu group attach agide. So eshne position aayitadaga second position aayitu. So name becomes 1, 2, 3 here, 2 methyl, yes, in which position methyl group is there? In second position there is a methyl group, right? Yes, in second position there is a substituent here. So then the name become 2-methoxy. Second position methoxy group is there, 2-methoxy propane. Hope it is clear. So this is how to name an organic compound which is having an ether as a functional group. Hope this is clear. Okay. Next we'll move on to the some of the physical properties, how it varies when you compare an ether with other compound. So in a physical property, especially we have to study about a boiling point. What is mean by that boiling point? When a given solution start to boil, that is what we call it as a boiling point, isn't it? So if you compare an alcohol ethers and an alkanes, if you compare these three, where all the three, especially alcohol, alkane, ethers, let us imagine dimethyl ether, okay, dimethyl ether, at that time what happens if you consider alkane, ether and alcohol, at that time all the three will have same molar masses. Imagine you have consider a compound where ethane is there, CH3 have an ethane, and you have an ether, dimethyl ether, and you have ethanol. Okay, you have ethane, that is an alkane, ether and alcohol. So if you compare it some molar mass, almost all the three will have a same molar mass. So when a molar mass is almost the same, we know that it will have almost similar boiling point, isn't it? Yes or no? Yes. When these three having almost same molar mass, it will have a almost same boiling point. But when you compare an alkane, ether and alcohol, these two have almost same boiling point, around 307. But this and this, which one? Ether and alcohol. So if this one has 307 Kelvin as a boiling point, this will have around 390 Kelvin as a boiling point. Why? Almost all the three is having the same masses, molar mass. Weight adrudu onde tara ide, but yen aagtade, boiling point vary aagta ide. What may be the reason behind this? Usually one mark question adu. What is the reason behind the variation of boiling point? Or nimma competitive exam alli kelthare, boiling point vary irodakke kaarana yenu anta. So ilenaitu, it is 307 Kelvin, it becomes a 390 Kelvin. Both have almost same molar mass, isn't it? So here also two carbon atom, here also it has a two carbon atom, here it has a six hydrogen, here also it has a six hydrogen, here it has only one oxygen, here this is also having only one oxygen. Structural formula, molecular formula, yella same ide, but boiling point alli variation ide. Yenakke irabodu adu? ಥಿಂಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದಾ ಯಾಕಿರ್ಬೋದು ಅಂತ. ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಥಿಂಕ್ ಇಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ಟೂ ಆಲ್ಕೈಲ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಒನ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್. ಎಸ್, ಟೂ ಆಲ್ಕೈಲ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಆರ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಒನ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಆಟಮ್. ವ್ಯಾರ್ ಆಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕೇಸ್, ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಟು ಅನ್ ಆಲ್ಕೋಹಾಲ್, ಒನ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಟು ದ ಆಲ್ಕೈಲ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್, ಎನದರ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಕನೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಟು ದ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್. ಹೇಗೆ ಒಂದು ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಆಲ್ಕೈಲ್ ಗ್ರೂಪಿಗೆ ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿದೆ, ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್, ಸೇಮ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಕಡೆ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನಿಗೆ ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿದೆ. ವೆರ್ ಆಸ್ ಇನ್ ಈಥರ್, ದಿಸ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಟು ದಿ ಆಲ್ಕೈಲ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಆನ್ ಐದರ್ ಸೈಡ್. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕಂಪೇರ್ ದೀಸ್ ಟು, ಆಲ್ಕೋಹಾಲ್ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಎನ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಬಾಂಡಿಂಗ್. ಎಸ್, ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಫ್ ಐ ರೈಟ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಸಿ ಟು ಎಚ್ ಫೈವ್ oxygen and H, right? There is an hydrogen bonding is observed between oxygen and hydrogen in alcohol. Whereas in ether, CH3O CH3, oxygen is not directly connected to the hydrogen, they are connecting to the carbon. So there is no hydrogen bonding here. No hydrogen bond here. Hydrogen bond is present within the molecule. So because of the hydrogen bond presence in the molecule, they are stronger one and it has a high boiling point. So therefore ether is always having a high boiling point compared to the ethers. Alcohol is always having a high boiling point compared to the ether. That is because of the presence of hydrogen bond in alcohol. Whereas in ether, that hydrogen bond is not present. Therefore, it is having a less boiling point. Hope it is clear. So that is regarding the physical property. Why the physical property vary in alcohol, ethers as well as in alkane. Although they have a same molar mass same idru kuda, boiling point ill vary ide. That is because of the presence of hydrogen bond in alcohol. That hydrogen bond is absent in the ether. So that is regarding the physical property. So now we know what are ethers, classification of ethers, nomenclature of ether, then physical properties of ether. Next we'll move on to the method of preparations of ether. How can you synthesize ether? That is method of preparation. How can you synthesize an ether? There are number of methods are there to prepare ether. In that we have to discuss few method in for the preparation of ether. In that, first one is by dehydration. By dehydration technique. So here we know that if we have an alcohol, let us imagine you have an alcohol. When an alcohol treating at 443 Kelvin in the presence of a dehydrating agent, sulfuric acid. We studied this. What is the product to form? Dehydration of ethanol leads to ethane. We discussed the mechanism also in the topic of alcohol. So we are going to get CH2 double bond CH2. So this is what we discussed in alcohol, very very important mechanism and all those things we discussed. So when that takes place, when a dehydrating agent, sulfuric acid is used, but the temperature you should maintain 443 Kelvin. So if I lower the temperature lower madidre helidre around 413 Kelvin, same using an dehydrating agent H2SO4. Using a dehydrating agent and at a temperature 413 Kelvin. So here what happens, we are going to get CH2, CH2, CH3. So formation of an ether. Formation of an ether is takes place. So why, when the same dehydrating agent is used in with the alcohol, we are going to get an alkene as well as sometime we are going to get an ether. So that is mainly because of the temperature we maintain during the reaction. So if your temperature is if you increase the temperature, that's by 443 Kelvin, then always elimination is predominate. So elimination agi always we are going to get an alkene. Okay, if the temperature is lower, that is 413 Kelvin kadime ide temperature untadre, then what happens, always substitution is predominate over the elimination. So eradu tara agutte, ondidu elimination reaction, innondu substitution reaction aagta ide illi. So lower the temperature, substitution is greater compared to the elimination. Okay, if higher the temperature, substitution is lower, elimination is more. In the sense, elimination is predominant over the substitution when a temperature is higher. So we are going to get an alkene. So we know the mechanism also there. So if temperature is lower, then substitution is predominate over the elimination, then we are going to get an ether as a product. So this is the first method to synthesize an ether by an alcohol. So remember, the temperature, lower temperature 413 Kelvin use madbeku, lower temperature irbeku, dehydrating agent ana use martiri. Yes, okay. So then how the reaction takes place? Reaction agod hegagadre, hope it is clear. I'll rub this. I'll write the equation again. So if we have CH3, CH2, OH, when it is treating with sulfuric acid dehydrating agent at 413 Kelvin, what happens? Here you are going to get CH3, CH2, O, CH2, CH3. Diethyl ether is formed as a product. Diethyl ether is formed as a product. How to get it? So here the reaction always takes place is SN2 mechanism. Substitution nucleophilic bimolecular reaction is takes place. So hope you remember what is SN2 mechanism as well as SN1 mechanism. We studied that in a chapter, haloalkanes and haloarenes. Substitution nucleophilic bimolecular reaction. So here substitution nucleophilic bimolecular reaction is takes place. SN2 mechanism is applicable good for the conversion of alcohol into an ether. So here step one is, I will write the mechanism so that it will be clear how an ether is formed. So if we have an alcohol, when it is treating with proton which is obtained from the sulfuric acid, so we are going to get CH3, CH2, O, H2 plus, yes, OH2 plus will be formed. So this one is again treating with another molecule of, you have to treat this with another molecule of alcohol. So here CH3, CH2, OH, OH. So here it is having a positive charge. So that what happens? So it has an oxygen which is having a lone pair of electron. That lone pair of electron will comes and attach to the carbon. At that time, this bond will get cleaved and water is eliminated. Yes, so we are going to get CH3, CH2. OH, CH2, CH3 with the liberation of water molecule. Yes, so new molecule of alcohol comes and attached to an protonated alcohol. So when oxygen which is having a lone pair of electron comes and attached to the carbon, at that time cleavage of a bond takes place, so water molecule get eliminated and the remain product is this one. So again we know that oxygen which is having the valency 2, here one hydrogen is there. What you can do, you can remove this hydrogen, so shifting of the bond takes place here. This bond here, it's a positive charge, so move to the next place. So we are going to get a product. This one. Hope it is clear. Okay. This will shift it to this position. So hydrogen is liberated. So again I thought CH3, CH2, O, CH2, CH3 as a product. So this is what we call this SN2 mechanism. So here substitution reaction is takes place, no elimination. Substitution reaction is takes place. So we are going to get ether as a product. So this is how one can synthesize an ether by dehydration phenomenon. So here first we have to treat an alcohol with a dehydrating agent sulfuric acid at a temperature of 413 Kelvin. You should remember this temperature. Lower temperature is very important for the conversion of alcohol into an ether. If you carry the reaction at high temperature, that is around 443 Kelvin, what happens? You are going to get an alkene. elimination is takes place. If you lower the temperature, then substitution is more pronounced compared to the elimination. Therefore, here if you have an alcohol, when you treat with the sulfuric acid at 413 Kelvin, formation of an ether takes place. So this is the mechanism. I'll repeat. So if you have an alcohol treating with a proton, that's obtained by a dehydrating agent. So extraction of a proton takes place. Therefore, protonated alcohol is formed. It is similar to the method in conversion of ethanol to ethene. So next, what happens? This protonated alcohol, when it is treating with another molecule of an alcohol, protonated alcohol, when it is treating with another molecule of alcohol, oxygen, which is having a lone pair of electron, that comes and attached to the carbon. So at that time, cleavage of a bond takes place, water molecule is eliminated. So then shifting of a bond takes place. So we are going to get an ether as a product. So that is regarding the conversion of alcohol into ether. So that is the first method of preparation of ether from an alcohol by using a dehydration technique. Hope this is clear. Usually in this technique we can prepare only primary ether. So if you have an secondary or a tertiary alcohol, then preparation of ether becomes very difficult in this phenomenon. So if you use an a secondary or a tertiary alcohol in the place of primary alcohol, then ether is not obtained as a product. You always we are going to get an alkene as a product. That is because, so if you use a primary and secondary and a tertiary alcohol there, earlier nanu primary alcohol alli tagond maadirtave, iga neevu aa place alli secondary athwa tertiary ide ant itkoli, at that time we are always get a product alkene, not an ether. That is because secondary tertiary idda koodle enaytu bulkier groups are attached to an alcohol group. At that time substitution becomes difficult, so elimination is more pronounced. Therefore always alkene is formed as a product yavaga when secondary and tertiary alcohol is used as a reactant. So if you use a primary, then it becomes always an ether. You should remember in this case the reaction always takes place at a lower temperature, not an higher temperature. So kadime temperature reaction adre we are going to get an substituted product, that is ether. If the temperature is higher, then elimination is more pronounced, therefore alkene is formed. So that is one of the method of preparation of an ether. So in the next class we are going to discuss about the method of preparation by a reaction, that is Williamson synthesis, and some substitution reactions are there. So that is regarding the ethers. We'll discuss the remaining things in the next class. Hope these things are clear.